it's Connecticut's most populous city. On just 19 square miles, Bridgeport, a multicultural oasis with a truly urban feel. And hidden in plain sight is Bridgeport's exceptional 24-mile waterfront. Just a block away in so many neighborhoods and concealed by industrial concrete and fences. But there's a new vision for this extraordinary waterfront. It's in the Bridgeport Waterfront Master Plan. A major transformation where the waterfront will be returned to its citizens and underused land will be turned into new economic opportunities.
Bridgeport has some of the greatest waterfront property between New York and Boston. And it's the most underutilized, probably in the country. This will be the first time in 30 years that we'll have an opportunity to really enjoy the waterfront. And I'm excited about it.
Bridgeport is not alone in this effort. Cities across the country are recapturing their waterfront, reestablishing connections cut off during the industrial booms of the 19th and 20th centuries. Buffalo, for example, has transformed a neglected industrial waterway into a nautical playground, adding parks and demolishing waterfront eyesores, initiating transformation and economic growth. Bridgeport can do the same. It can become Connecticut's premier waterfront city. Three major concepts will drive this forward. First, a citywide waterfront pathway. Walk, jog, or just stroll. Bike, enjoy, relax under the stars along a 20-mile continuous pathway along estuaries, creeks, rivers, and the Long Island Sound.
I think the pathway is like a brilliant idea to really connect all those points that have been cut off for so long. It's a great way for people to see the rest of the city, or to connect with neighbors, or you know, to connect with friends, or just to, you know, make an entire day of just, you know, riding up and down the coastline from one end to the other.
Next, community-driven vision plans for the redevelopment of six major opportunity sites along the Pequannock River and Yellow Mill Channel areas. And finally, the rebirth, the reactivation of the waterfront through events, recreation, food, art installations, and other attractions.
The waterfront gives us a wonderful amenity to access that is cost-free. You know, it brings people out. I think once the general public knows that this pathway is coming and that some of the areas are being opened up, it's a great opportunity for RFPs to go out for land development, for entrepreneurs to start utilizing their skills and literally dive into a whole new economic opportunity and just fun.
And we need to be cognizant of the things that are water-dependent uses, things that provide access to opportunities, places for people to live. Not just places for people to live, but places people want to live.
The Bridgeport Waterfront Plan. The city will launch this transformation by creating pieces of the public pathway. But the work cannot continue without citizens joining the fold. The energy and engagement of Bridgeport residents is key. Join community meetings, work with local groups to organize waterfront cleanups, and outdoor activities like biking, boating, and more. Get involved. Help create a public waterfront that works for everyone.
I love the idea of having activities that get more people in the water. I think like the sense that you get when you're in Seaside in the middle of the summer, where you're just like, there's so much energy, there's so many different cultures represented, there's so much, like you go there and you're like, oh, this feels like Bridgeport. It makes you happy to be there and it makes you proud of your city.
It's Bridgeport's hidden gem, the waterfront.